Henry's ruthlessness knows no end, the former commander of the armies of the fallen King Richard the Lionheart now sheds blood in the name of paying taxes owed to King John. The stigma of suffering hangs over an oppressed people. The evil and destruction sown by Henry is compounded by the rule of the murderous Sheriff of Nottingham. Together they plan another plot to end the life of the last of the Locksley family, Robin.
What a sight for sore eyes! Praised be the day, for our good friend Robin is finally back. And just as I had feared, he looks absolutely horrendous. By Mary, Robin, did you lose a fight to a bear? What trouble did you get into this time?
Don't even ask. And it's not like you'd really believe in my misadventures anyway.
Well, you are a master of cock and bull stories after all. And yet, I do notice you are quite parched and exhausted. Why don't you go and have a snack and rest in your hut for now? Do not fret or worry about anything else at the moment. There is no work that cannot wait until tomorrow dawn. Ah, the morning breeze sure is wonderful today. And look at yourself, friend. A night's sleep has really done you a favour. Are you fully awake yet, though? I see your trusty bow is missing.
I didn't forget it, Brother Tuck. And it hurts me to say that, but I've lost it on my way home. And Lady Marion as well, as I can't seem to find her.
Is that so? In that case, get up and work the axe, for you are in need of a new bow. The wood should be good enough for both the stave and the arrows. An effortless task for a man like you, eh? You could probably buy one from a merchant, but since we are in a dire need of a bowman, you can have the bowstring I have been carrying around. And do not worry about our Lady Marion, for she is off to forage for herbs. Come back to me after you have finished crafting your new friend, because I have a few ideas for tasks I could assign you to. Would you look at that? I would say that bow seems prettier than your old one. No offence to your old companion, of course.
None taken. I can't say how comfortable it feels to have one on me again.
God has been kind to you, Robin, so why not repay him with some good deeds for the community? Silwich could use your help. You see, dear Robin, hunting without a skilled bowman left us short on meat. Would I be wrong to assume that taking on some deer should not be too much of a challenge for you today? I see you are back, alive and well. Hopefully, you are bringing good news along with you. Were you able to hunt down some deer?
It's almost like you're forgetting who you're talking to, Brother Tuck. Here it is. And it's still warm to the touch. I only hope it's enough for the community.
By the grace, yes. And now that our people will not have to worry about food, they can finally get to work properly. And that means you need not rest for too long now. If we want to be effective, we, and by that I mean you, need to gather more resources for the village's expansion as soon as possible.
Sounds like another invigorating task. What would you like me to fetch?
Just some rocks for the furnace I have got a blueprint of, my friend. We need something to smelt the iron ore into ingots if we want to have good tools.
So be it then. I will be back when I have enough.
Finally, Silwich has its own furnace. Imagine all the tools you could make with its help. However...
Aren't we lacking a smithy to make them?
Precisely, dear Robin. I did not want to put too much work on your back at once, but it is a necessity. Please take this pickaxe, because we are going to need ores for that. Come back when you have enough.
Sorry, Robin, but we can't risk leaving until we hear word from the other places that the road is safe. Maybe if you went there and checked it yourself first.
this thing, Lord.
Bastards.
It is a day of sorrow indeed. Our beloved grandmother Matilda fell victim to a beastly bear. For the good of our people, please kill it before it causes another such tragedy.
I can't believe it. I'll get to it right away. Do you know where I could likely find that bear?
It should still be lurking around our dear Matilda's house, somewhere around Westford, maybe sitting in its den. What a foul creature. I need to warn you, though, that bear is infamously large. Even with your commendable hunting skills, a barrage of arrows will not be enough to put it down. We do have a blacksmith now, so maybe you could get a sword. Hopefully a sword will be enough. Hopefully.
And how is the day going for you? Salutations.
Nice weather we're having.
Is there anything you need?
Where would you like to go, Robin?
Hello.
Would you like to go, Robin?
Robin, how glad I am to see you right now. Word is there is a convoy nearby, and that this convoy is transporting a bunch of imprisoned folk. Surely you will find that worth looking into. Right, Robin?
Surely I will. We need to help those people. How much time do we have to attack?
Enough to make proper preparation, that is for sure. Our men are willing to fight, but we need to arm them first.
Leave that to me. I will fetch the weapons and we'll be on our way.
Good, and I will reach out to our men and tell them to get ready. Bring us the weapons once you have them.
bear.
The weapons already, and we still have time to get to the hiding spot near Fort. I will pass those weapons to the people and tell them to move. Meet them there.
It's a nice morning, isn't it?
Brace yourselves, everyone. Robin is here. Should we set up an ambush for the convoy already?
Yes. It's about time.
Brace yourselves, everyone. Robin is...
Yes, it's about time.
Oh!
Brace yourselves, everyone.
Yes, it's about time.
Lucky we are to be freed by Robin himself. Please, Robin, if you have the men and arms to spare, save the rest of us too. The other peasants are kept in the knight's castle, and God knows what those knights are going to do to them. Is there anything you need? Hello. How's your day, sir? Thank you. today. I owe my life to you, mate. Say, are you in need of a henchman? Let me just grab one of the guard's swords and help you out.
The more the merrier, isn't it? Come along.
Robin, it really is. I cannot believe my eyes. Oh, thank God and the heavens above.
You're not hurt, are you? We need to get out of here before anything worse happens.
Black Henry's reign is over, and the kidnapped Lady Miriam has been rescued. When this news reaches the ears of the Sheriff of Nottingham, the forests of Sherwood will have to face an evil they have never known before.